Hello everyone, I'm Bryce and welcome to my vlog. Now, typically we'd be taking an adventurous dive into the unnecessary together, but today I actually want to talk to you about my ideal budget vlogging camera for 2018, as well as slip in some advice for those of you who might be wanting to start a vlog of your own. So if at any point any of that interests you, then stay tuned. Now, everyone's first question that they ask when starting their vlog is, what camera should I buy? The answer to that is extremely based on your personal use case, but for 95% of you who are starting video recording and video editing for the first time, you may be surprised that the camera I would recommend may just already be in your pocket. When you first start dreaming of recording a vlog and you start thinking about the camera you're gonna be using, a lot of people tend to think of something like this, a DSLR or mirrorless camera. Now, don't get me wrong, these are amazing and they have beautiful image quality because they're made specifically for image processing, but they also come with a hefty price tag and an even steeper learning curve. This is actually the first camera I ever purchased for myself. It's a Canon T3i that I snagged back in 2011. 7 years later, I'm still using it, but quite honestly, it's taken me that long to really figure out how to use it. DSLRs and mirrorless cameras, a lot like this one, offer a lot of control. They help you get that perfect shot that you have cooking up inside your brain. But the problem is that often takes a lot of technical knowledge to truly understand and get it to its full capability, as well as sometimes you really need expensive gear to get the right motion or the right shot that you're looking for. That's why I do not suggest starting with something like that, like I did. Learn from my mistakes, start small, work your way up. Please learn from my mistakes. So, my ideal budget vlogging camera in 2018 is actually, drumroll please, a smartphone. Now hear me out. I'm in no way trying to say that you can easily squeeze the image quality of like a DSLR or a mirrorless camera out of your smartphone, but to their credit, they have gotten increasingly better at producing video. In fact, the entirety of this episode was shot exclusively on my personal Galaxy S8. I am not sponsored to say that, it's just a fact. And beyond video quality, which as we know is really important and we all want to have crystal clear images, but beyond that, smartphones have some features that cameras don't readily have. For example, continuous autofocus, or the idea that your equipment will be able to continually autofocus or keep you in focus while you move during the shot. Something that cell phones have actually had for a really long time, but my T3i does not have that feature. Well, Bryce, your camera is from 2011. I hear you, concerned citizen. I get it. My camera is old, but here's the thing. Even in 2018, continuous autofocus is not a feature that is as widespread as you would think in the prosumer camera lineup. It's actually kind of a cost prohibitive feature. So, if you're a new vlogger and you're new to video production, video editing, the whole thing, you're gonna want continuous autofocus if you plan on moving at all during your vlog. So just trust me, it's like a quality of life thing. You want continuous autofocus. Smartphones are also pretty good at doing things like auto white balance and auto exposure that surprisingly pro level cameras are not necessarily gonna be great at, but that's mostly because they're designed for people who know how to do manual shooting a lot better and really get to that image. So smartphones are just user friendly. And if you're brand new, that's what you need, trust me. Dips your toe in, you get a little bit of it, just enough to see if you like it. And then if you do, then you can go all in on other equipment. So I know that was a really long-winded way in a video to say basically shoot with your smartphone, but seriously, it's the best equipment you can get your hands on, especially if you're new and you're not sure if you even like the hobby. Had my smartphone been as good as they are now when I started, I would have definitely started with that before I bought my Canon T3i. So use this as a learning tool if you've never done any video editing whatsoever. And there's a helicopter overhead. If you like this content, let me know. I have plans to potentially take on things like audio and other video equipment that might be great for beginning vloggers. So if you're interested in that, let me know in the comments. Smash that like button. And if you didn't like this content, I still expect you to smash that like button because I am sensitive and my feelings are fragile. And I just wanted to take a moment to thank my voluntary production assistant, Stacy, who stepped up to make sure that my tall, lengthy self was still in frame throughout the day and speeding up our production process. So big thanks to her. She has killed it. So thank you, Stacy, and have a great day, and we'll see you in the next one.